Good morning. I do have a couple of program announcements to make. Right after Sarah does the eulogy, we're going to share a video. There will be opportunities for people to share memories and stories downstairs in our fellowship hall. And then there will be no formal receiving line, but you know Diane is going to want to hug everyone here. And so Diane and Sarah and David and all of you, I share with you the agony of your grief, the anguish of your heart finds echo in my own. I know I cannot enter all you feel, nor bear with you the burden of your pain. I can but offer what my love does give, the strength of caring, the warmth of one who seeks to understand, the silent, storm-swept barrenness of such a great loss. And this I will do in quiet ways, that on your lonely path you may not walk alone. A month ago, no one could have possibly predicted that you'd be here on this beautiful Saturday morning saying goodbye to David Anthony. That couldn't have been in anyone's mind. That means this past month, this past stretch has been especially difficult, heart-wrenching, filled with sadness. If we could script our days, David would have gotten up and gone to work today. He would have texted throughout the day with his sister, Sarah, maybe later called Diane. And he would have ended the day like he ended so many days, watching the sunset. But we don't get to script our days, and sadly, life isn't fair. When an older adult dies, it feels like the end of our past. But when a young adult dies, it feels like the end of our future. Life is so very fragile and fleeting. And so we come here today to be in the shelter of each other's love and care, with tears in our eyes and aching pain in our hearts. We come to be with people because we come here because we need to be with people who loved David. And we know that faces hide as much as they reveal, and things aren't always what they seem to be. Too many people simply see reality as what they can see and touch, but feelings are very real as well. And however tragic and upsetting and painful David's death was, this day the family and friends must remember that he is no longer trapped in a place that he no longer chose to be. And here's what each of us knows, that David Anthony was loved, and we know that David loved and cared about his friends and family and the people he worked with. We know also that he had a unique ability to touch the lives of people in significant ways. No doubt this past stretch, all of you have been telling stories about the adventures and good times you had. He used his love of life to encourage and enrich others. And for most of his days, he had a passion and a zeal for living, always, always enjoying the moment, always knowing how to have a good time, whether he was at home or work, anywhere he lived fully. Please join me in a word of prayer. Let there be no whispering, no secrets. Our hearts have been broken. David Anthony, whom we loved, is no longer here. And our hearts ache, and we feel we will never be the same. Source of compassion, help us. Help us and hold us together. Help us to live with life's unanswerable questions and those normal feelings we all have of anger and guilt and this huge hole of loss. Help us to discover healing as we reach out to others who are suffering, to find the courage to show them our love, to say the kind word. The sun sets and rises. We put one foot in front of the other. We hold our hearts in our hands. We give them up to you, O God of eternal peace, and to each other. Help us to live this day with courage and grace. Amen.
Ooh. birds fly, and the dreams that you dream, those dreams really do come true.
Thank you, Cindy and Carolyn. Throughout the centuries, in moments of sadness, people have looked to the scriptures, and a great source of comfort, hope, and promise comes from the familiar words of the 23rd Psalm. It's printed in your program. Please read it in unison with me. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest the table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Most of you knew David a lot better than I did, so my words aren't all that important. But I do know a few things. He enjoyed life. That he was a happy, contented soul, and he didn't need a lot of things or endless wealth to have a good time. He had a huge heart and would do anything for anyone. And I know he adored his sister, Sarah. I think he liked his brother, Steve, as well, but he adored. And it never bothered him living in her shadow or being known as Sarah's brother. And when you look at those early pictures, and there's lots of wonderful pictures downstairs, when you look at those, when he was just a little squirt, the smile of his revealed so much. From his very first breath, he was the happiest child. Happy, but known to get into some good mischief over the years. Quick to pull a prank, but never mean-spirited or malicious. So many good stories to be shared. The couch he took to the village to watch his sister play, I think, soccer. What was it? Oh, okay. And then he was gifted with his hands. He could fix just about anything. Unlike a lot of men, he was a good cleaner, cleaning and organizing Diane's basement and garage. And if you go into her backyard, and we did that yesterday, you can witness David's creative touch, a little area by the stream, a table made out of a big trunk and chairs. It's a tranquil slice of heaven right there in Diane's backyard. So I don't know if David Anthony had a favorite Bible verse, but here's the one he lived every single day. Whatever your hands find to do, do with all your might. At some point when your hearts aren't so broken, make a trip to Key West and go snorkeling or jet skiing in his memory. Stroll down Duval Street and visit some of the places you did with him. And end the day at Fort Zachary and catch the sunset. And as you do those things, let tears fall from your eye. And then let happy memories bring you back to a better place. Diane, here's the final thing I know, that you and Stephen, your husband, gave your David the best possible life imaginable, not just by providing for him, but by loving him day after day through all of his ups and downs. He was blessed by you. And all of us feel privileged and honored to know and loved him. We are better people because of David Anthony's life. But I bet if he were here, he'd look each one of you in the eyes and say, no, I was the lucky one to have you in my corner. So now I just invite all of you to close your eyes. And in the holiness of this moment, in the sacredness of this place, just let pictures of your David come to mind. Whisper a quiet thank you for his love and friendship. But don't simply build a shrine in your heart to his memory. Live the good life. Love the people entrusted to your care so that your life, like his, will be worthy of remembrance and celebration for years to come. Amen. And now Sarah's going to share some thoughts. She was told to picture all of you naked, but that's a sight I don't want to go to.
What a beautiful view I have standing here today as we have come together to celebrate our brother David's life. From where I am standing, I am overwhelmed and privileged to see the faces that are not just present here today, but the faces that have been present throughout David's life. You see, each one of you has played a role in what has made David's life full. For that, and for each of you, I would like to start by thanking you on behalf of myself and my family. I would also like to thank the Guilford Community Church for making this celebration entirely possible. I am continuously blown away by the teamwork from all of you, and from all of the parishioners who not only embrace their own with love and generosity, but they far extend their arms to all of those in need. So for all of you, thank you very much. So here we are, August 21st. I've had just over 6 weeks to prepare for this day, and yet I still don't have answers to the questions that have been running through my mind day after day. How could I possibly stand here to summarize you in the incredible person that you are? As a wonderful son, brother, nephew, cousin, grandson, uncle, godfather, and friend, where do I begin trying to pick the best memory to tell? How do I find the right words to finalize who you were here with us? I may never know, But one thing I do know is it absolutely must start with the word dude. So, dude, you would never believe the impact you have had on so many lives. We have had the privilege of seeing your impact both in life and now in your unimaginable passing. I have also had the privilege of loving you my whole life. A gift not granted to all, but for this and for you, I will be forever thankful. David was not only funny, he was kind, always willing to help in a way, any way he could. And not just your average help either. David's help always was to the fullest and never half done. In fact, we could say the same for how he lived his life, never half done. Which I will say worked out really well for us when we would ask for help stacking wood. Because to David, that meant stack the whole three cords in one day, which could be part of why he started visiting in the summer and not in the fall. David loved people in a way that was truly beautiful, always accompanied by an infectious laugh and a genuine feeling that you truly meant the world to him, no matter how short or long that time may have been spent. David had more movie quotes ready to reference than anyone I had ever met, along with an endless supply of jokes and fun, useless trivia, thanks to his favorite gifts from Auntie Nancy. Hockey, he looked so forward to getting those every time you sent them. It is fair to say that to have known David, you can easily be reminded of a time that he made you laugh or smile. And what is beautiful, as I stand here, every single person sitting here today has a memory of my brother. With that said, let us please take a moment of remembrance to reflect on a memory that you have. With this, for this moment, we can fill this room with David. And I would like to share a memory with you. One of the times I was taking David back to the airport, I was driving, I can still hear him laughing. As we were driving up to the terminal, there was a large billboard that read, "Spirit Airlines now offers more legroom." I actually repeated it out loud the second time with more French inflection. Legroom. With a genuine confusion as to whether or not Spirit was a French airline. And I could feel him staring at me. And as I pulled up to the drop-off, he was still staring at me, followed by an immediate, "Dude, are you serious?" I didn't even finish college, and even I know that that said legroom. He laughed so hard that I can still hear him laughing, but we debated at that time about whether or not legroom really was one word or two. So after this, if you look up the word, you can see where my confusion came from. David was always quick to remind me of how smart I was. But he was equally quick to remind me of how much he loved me. I can also say with complete confidence that if you're sitting here right now, he would have been quick to remind you of just how much he loved you as well. I will be forever grateful for the way David loved, the way his big blue eyes would light up, the way his big crooked smile would appear, showing his huge dimples, as he was preparing to tell a joke or laughing at one of yours. David, I can only hope that you know that we all loved you the same way back, and we would have done anything to have made you okay. I would also like to say how proud I am of you, how proud we all are of you, how even through the mess at times, I was most often in complete amazement of how you still always found your way. Your life was not always easy. Your life was not always fully understood by us, but your life here was full. With this, we feel peace that you were ready to pass, ready to rest, and ready to trust that we would be here to honor you, respect you, and continue to love you here for always. So as we stay here, David, continuing your life through words, memories, pictures, and acts of kindness, there are a few promises that we would like to make to you. We promise to laugh more, treat people better, tell the big stories, and get lost every once in a while, but always know the road home. We promise that we will find purpose in your passing. We will remember to love people while they are here and forgive those while we have the time. That we will be reminded of the importance of truth, the importance of trusting others with telling your truths and allowing others to help when life gets too heavy. But most of all, we promise to understand, embrace, and teach the importance of being brave enough to say the words, "I am not okay." When I stood in this very spot speaking of my dad 3.5 years ago, I chose to end by sharing what I only imagine he would have wanted to share one last time. So today, I would like to do the same for David. What would he like to tell each one of you sitting here, if he were here right now? Thank you for loving me in your own way. Do not mourn in my memory, for sadness does not belong there. Instead, keep me alive by telling my stories, laughing out loud, and being at peace with the good times that we shared. Do not hold guilt in your heart. My passing will never offer you closure. Perhaps because my time with you was not meant to be closed. I did not live in missed calls or see you next times. So when you miss me, close your eyes. Go back to a great time that we shared, and I promise to meet you there. And from all of us to you, David, we can only hope that you are knee deep in the water somewhere. You've got the blue sky breeze blowing wind through your hair, and the only worry in your world is the tide going to reach your chair. We all love you so very much.
Thank you, Sarah.
Pretend I don't live in it. Sunshine gonna wash my blues away. Had sweet love, but I lost it. She got too close so far, and now I'm lost in the world trying to find me a better way. Wishing I was deep, deep in the water somewhere. Got the blue sky breeze and it don't seem fair. Only worry in the world is the tide gonna reach my chair. Sunrise, there's a fire in the sky. Never been so happy, never felt so high. And I think I might have found me my own kind of paradise. Wrote a note, sent me back in a minute. Bought a boat and I sailed off in it. Don't think anybody's gonna miss me anyway. Is my only medication, wishing my condition ain't ever gonna go away. Cause now I'm deep, deep in the water somewhere. Got the blue sky breeze blowing wind through my hair. Only worry in the world is the tide gonna reach my chair. Sunrise, there's a fire in the sky. Never been so happy, never felt so high. And I think I might have found me my own kind of paradise. This champagne shore washing over me. It's a sweet, sweet life, living by the salty sea. One day you could be as lost as me. Change your geography. Maybe you might be. Knee deep in the water somewhere. Got the blue sky breeze blowing wind through my hair. Only worry in the world is the tide gonna reach my chair. Sunrise, there's a fire in the sky. Never been so happy, never felt so high. And I think I might have found me my own kind of paradise. Come on in, the water's nice. Find yourself a little slice. Grab a backpack and lines. You never know until you try. When you lose yourself, you find the key to paradise.
Just as free. as your soul and spirit fly into mystic.
There are places I remember all my life, though some have changed, some forever, not for better. Some have gone, and some remain. All those places had their moments with lovers and friends. I still can recall, some are dead and some are living. In my life I've loved them all. But of all these friends and lovers, there is no one compares with you. And these memories lose their meaning when I think of love as something new. Though I know I'll never lose affection for people and things that went before, I know I'll often stop and think about them. In my life I love you more. Though I know I'll never lose affection for people and things that went before, I know I'll always stop and think about them. In my life I love you more. In
thank you, Cindy and Carolyn, and on behalf of Diane and her family, I thank you not only for your presence here this morning, but for all of the love and support you've showed them and will continue to share with them. Please join us downstairs in our fellowship hall for some delicious food. It smelled great in the church the last 2 days, and even some better stories. And may we go forth holding on to this idea that a life well lived doesn't end any more than music ends. It echoes through time with whispers of beauty and grace. If we listen, we can hear the encore with our hearts, for the song plays on, as surely as David's love will always live on. Amen.